Hello everyone, this is Mario. Welcome to the biggest and most anticipated cycling race of the season, the Tour de France 2019. So this is the big one, the one that most riders prepare to during the season. It's the main objective of many of the top riders in the World Tour Peloton. And this year's race will cover 3,465 kilometers along 9 flat stages, two of which are time trials, one team time trial on the second stage, and a single individual time trial of the race on the 13th stage. We also have 5 hilly stages, although some of which may actually be challenged by some of the sprinters that can hang in the final few hills. And of course, the most awaited stages of this race, the mountain stages, this year we'll have 7 stages considered as mountainous, and 4 of which have summit finishes. So the route is quite interesting, and of course, as usual, most of the mountain stages are in the second and third weeks of the race, and we can actually say that it's on the 12th stage that the GC will start to be shaped. So as usual, I will be riding this Tour de France with the official start list of the race. And this time, I decided to go with the Koenig Quickstep, a team that I actually never played with before. And of course, my GC leader will be Enric Mas, the Spanish rider that finished second in La Vuelta in 2018. And I will try to aim a top 5 finish with him. He's not the best rider in time trials, so that will hinder a bit his goal of the top 5 finish, but still I will try to make the difference with him in the mountain stages. Of course, in my team I also have Elie Viviani as the top sprinter. He will be one of the favorites for the sprint stages, so I expect to win a few of them with him. Also, I will try to challenge for the green jersey, the points classification jersey, with Elie Viviani. And of course, the other goal I will have for the team is to try to win the mountain classification, the polka dot jersey, with Julien Alaphilippe. He was the winner of that jersey in the 2018 edition of the Tour de France, and I will try to win that again with him. Of course, I also expect to take one or two stage wins with Alaphilippe if possible. So as I said, my main goal with Enric Mas is to get a top 5 finish, but the competition for that will be really strong. I can easily count 15 other riders capable of getting a top 5 finish. Let's check them. For instance, in Age Desert we have Romain Bardet. We have Jakob Fuglsen for Astana. In Bahrain Merida, we have Vincenzo Nibali and Rohan Dennis. Bora Hansgrohe with Patrick Conrad and Emmanuel Buchmann. Education First, we have Rigoberto Urán and TJ Van Garderen. In Groupama FTG, we have Thibaut Pinot, who actually I have kind of a feeling that he will do very well in the real life race. This year. I think he's a really strong candidate this year. We also have Steven Kruijswijk for Team Jumbo-Visma. We have Ilnur Zakarin for Team Katusha. Mitchelton Scott brings both Yates brothers, Simon and Adam. Movistar has a really strong squad with Nairo Quintana and Mikel Landa challenging for the GC, and also Alejandro Valverde with a strong chance of getting a good classification. Then we have probably the strongest team in the race, Team Ineos, with Geraint Thomas and Egan Bernal challenging in the GC. Team Sunweb, not bringing Tom Dumoulin due to injury, has Wilco Kelderman, also capable of challenging in the GC. Trek Segafredo bring Bauke Mollema and Richie Porte, and Team Emirates bring Dan Martin. As for the riders challenging Elie Viviani for the sprint stages and the green jersey, we have André Greipel from Arkea Samsic, although he is far from being the top contender here. Also, we have Sonny Colbrelli in Bora Hansgrohe. Of course, Peter Sagan is going to challenge for sprints and the green jersey. Jumbo Visma brings probably the strongest sprinter in this tour, Dylan Groenewegen. We also have Caleb Ewan for Lotto Soudal, Matteo Trentin in Mitchelton Scott. And without Fernando Gaviria, Team Emirates brings Alexander Kristoff as their top sprinter. So here we are for the start of the 2019 Tour de France. This year's race begins in Belgium, in the capital city of Belgium, Brussels. I would like to start by apologizing because in the early kilometers of the stage, there is a bit of a lag with my computer. It's basically because of the high detail of this stage. It's really beautifully made, but of course, it strains a bit my laptop. So apologies for that. So in this first stage, the favorites are of course the sprinters. And I will try to win the stage with Elia Viviani. So I will not put any of my riders in the breakaway today, and will simply focus in trying to win the stage in the final sprint. One interesting thing in this stage is that although it's still a long with many kilometers to go in the stage, the riders will be in Gerardsbergen. They will tackle the Kapelmoer and the Bosberg in the early kilometers of the stage. But of course, it's not expected to have a big impact in the race. And we have the first fall of the race. Rui Costa, the Portuguese, the former world champion, has fallen, but he can continue in the race. And as you can see, this is one of the big things of the new game of Pro Cycling Manager 2019, in which now you can have, sometimes in the middle of the peloton, a single rider falling without taking everyone else with him. So with a bit more than 40 kilometers in this stage, we have a five-man breakaway group now reaching the Kapelmoer. We have Rosseto, Ofredo and De Gendt for Wanty, and they are leaving everyone else behind. We also have Simon Geschke and Michael Schaar here for CCC. And it's Ofredo is going really fast on the Kapelmoer, leaving everyone else behind and taking the 2 points for the Category 3 climb at the top of the Kapelmoer. Then Michael Schaar got the other point. And wow, Rosseto is having a real big trouble going over the Kapelmoer. We have a puncture by Michael Woods, but it's probably not going to cause a big issue. He's still in the peloton. The pace is quite slow, so no one is probably going to be left behind. Quite a few punctures in the climb of the Kapelmoer, but everyone is still going to stay in the race. Although Cherel for AG Dazer is having a big trouble following the pace. So let's see if he doesn't get dropped here. So now with 85 kilometers to go, the riders in the breakaway are 7 kilometers away from the intermediate sprint of this stage. And unlike in other races, where you have, when you have a breakaway, you don't really care about what happens in the peloton in the intermediate sprint. But this time I will care about that, because in the Tour de France, there are plenty of points left. So after those four riders go through, they will take 20, 17, 15, and 13 points. There will still be plenty of points left. So I'm trying to do a small train with Murkov, Richese, and Viviani for Viviani to sprint. So we are getting close now. 2 kilometers almost to go for the sprint. Let's try to sprint now with Richese And now launch Elia Viviani. Let's see if he can get the points here. Go on, Viviani. I think it was only second. Yeah, it was second, so it was after Michael Matthews. So in the breakaway, we still have three riders left. We have Johan Ofredo, Michael Schaar, and Simon Geschke. They are now a little over 2 kilometers away from the final KOM point of this day. It's the climb to the Côte de Boisdet. Simon Geschke is launching the attack. Is he going to be the first one here? Let's see. And no, it's going to be Johan Ofredo. Johan Ofredo taking the point here. And he now leads with 4 points against Michael Schaar's single point. So with almost 20 kilometers to go and only two riders in the breakaway group with less than a minute over the peloton, the stage will definitely be decided in a mass sprint. And I'm going to start assembling my sprint train. So the breakaway has been caught. We are 11 kilometers away from the finish. Let's start using the energy gels on our riders. Jasper Philipsen has fallen. Oh, and he took a lot of other riders. Rowan Dennis is one of them. Let's try to focus on my sprint train now. I don't want to be bothered with that. And I'm really sorry about the lag that you can surely see in the stage. We are now going under these two tunnels in Brussels. We are 7 kilometers away from the finish, approaching really fast. And soon I will have Kasper Asgreen pacing. Let's go with Asgreen now. Energy gel on Richese and Viviani as well. Also, let's use it in Enric Mas. Let's try to prepare this the best way we can. Soon I'll be starting the sprint. Let's start the sprint now with Murkov. And 1.5 kilometers to go. Let's go with Richese now. And now with Viviani. Can Viviani take the stage win? It's him or Christoph, and Alexander Christoph is taking the win in the first stage. Elia Viviani is second, and Peter Sagan is third. Ah, it was by inches that I could not take the stage win with Elia Viviani. Alexander Christoph, a surprise winner, actually. He was surely not one of the top three favorites. So here is the replay of this final sprint. It was a little uphill. Elia Viviani looked like he could take the stage win, but then Alexander Christoph was a little bit stronger in the end and took the stage win for Emirates. So the Norwegian rider taking the first stage of the Tour de France 2019. I managed second with Elia Viviani. It's not a bad result. But of course, it's not a stage win. So, I hope I can do better in the next chance for a stage win in the sprint. Of course, Alexander Christoph is the first leader of the general classification after taking the win in this stage. The first wearer of the polka dot jersey is Johan Ofredo. He got 4 points in this first stage. And of course, with his win today, Alexander Christoph is also the leader in the points classification. So in the next stage, Elia Viviani is going to be the wearer of the green jersey. And having finished in the top 20, Enric Mas was actually the best young rider in this stage, so he will be wearing the white jersey in the next stage. And we start off well in the team classification, although all teams have the same time, but the Koenig Quickstep is the leader. So this stage ended as expected in a mass sprint finish. Although with the fall that happened in the final kilometers of the stage, some riders lost time in the GC, especially Rowan Dennis. He's already 3 minutes and 46 down on the general classification. Also in that fall, Jasper Philipsen withdrew from the race. He was forced to abandon. No riders were actually out of time limit in the stage, but Michael Scherel just made it by 2 minutes, I think. So it was really close for the French rider of Ager Désert. So looking at the next stage, it's going to be a team time trial, 26.9 kilometers long. It's a flat one, and it's going to be the first stage creating some differences between GC contenders. Of course, with no surprise, Team Ineos is the favorite, is the top favorite for this stage. As for my team, the Koenig Quickstep, it comes up in 8th in the favorites list for this stage. So it's not ideal. I know I don't have the best riders for time trials, but I will try to do my best to not lose much time in this stage. So I hope you have enjoyed the beginning of this Tour de France. It was only by little that I did not manage to take a stage win in the first stage. And so if you have enjoyed it, please like my video. Also, please leave a comment down below. Tell me what you think I should have done better. And also, please give me your feedback on what you think I should improve in my videos, on what you would like to see me focus in this series. Also, if you haven't done so yet, please feel free to subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate the support, and I hope to see you all next time for stage 2 of the Tour de France 2019 in Pro Cycling Manager. Bye!